Today we're going to talk about salt and your low carb diet. Hey there, NJRoot22.com here with another low carb keto carnivore chat. And today it's about salt. I'm not going to get all freaking technical about salt. I want to say one thing, and if you haven't read it yet, read this book. Go on Amazon, find the link in my blog, go on my blog, and I have an affiliate link there. I'll try to remember to put the link in my description here. It's a book called Salt Your Way to Health from Dr. Brownstein, whatever his name is. It's a very profoundly excellent book. You won't find many of them out there like this. It basically, and I'll sum it up for you. There's two kinds of salts. There's the salt everybody's been using. It's the table salt. And then there's the there's sea salts. We'll talk about that in a minute. But table salt, you need to understand, is completely different than unrefined, unprocessed sea salts. Table salt has, there's like over 80 minerals inside unprocessed salt. I can't even list them all. I'm not even going to try. Table salt is just pure sodium. They removed all the other ingredients from the salt taste, and it's just sodium. Whereas sea salts, in general, have its they're unprocessed and they have all the ingredients that came along with the salt. There's, I think, 85 or 100 different minerals and other substances in there. And one of them is actually arsenic, and there's all sorts of other things in there. And a lot of people are like, oh, it has arsenic in it. But arsenic isn't bad for you. Just look up why Johnny Appleseed, an apple a day keeps the doctor away, because the apple seeds actually had vitamin, I forget the Laetril in it, and that had arsenic in it too, but it's in small quantities, it's not toxic to you. The whole point is that table salt, the regular table salt, is actually bad for you. The sodium alone is just bad for you. It's an acidic compound, and even though it tastes exactly the same for the most part as sea salts, it's just bad for you. It's acidic and it's bad for your body. That's why they always say, oh, low salt diet, la, la, la. But sea salts are actually beneficial for your body. And they're alkaline in composition. And it's just good for you to eat a lot of sea salt. And I'm not going to get into all the different sea salts. We have a couple favorites that I would like to think about. And also, there's two ways to cook, to use sea salt. One is during the preparation or preparing of your cooked foods. That means when you're making a sauce or you're putting it inside your burgers or what have you. In my opinion, you could probably just use any kind of sea salt in moderation. You don't want to use too much, because there are some sea salts out there that have a profoundly saltier taste, if I have to say. There's almost too salty. I can't explain the taste difference, but I notice it. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But there's this one brand out there called Real Salt. They're based out of Utah. I'm not sponsored by them or anything, but I've tasted, I don't know, 100 different sea salts, and that one is perfect to me. It's perfect on all counts. It has this nice flavor. It's not too salty. It's not, there's nothing wrong with it. I'll put a link in my description or in my blog post as well. And that's the kind of salt you want to use while cooking. But then there's a second profoundly different kind of salt as well for at your dinner table or lunch table, whatever table you're eating at. And that's called a finishing salt. And this is salt that usually has more texture. It doesn't have to have texture technically, but these finishing salts, something about them, because they are larger in size, they're usually salt flakes, and we like Malden sea salt flakes. They're unbelievable. You put it on top of your food or your salad or whatever you're eating, and you crunch it on, and they're flakes. You don't want to use the whole flakes usually, because they're a little bit too big, but you crunch them onto your food, and they just bring the flavor to the surface, and they're really just incredible. So that's basically it. I mean, give them a try. I mean, finishing salts are definitely something, I guess, that higher end cooks use and more advanced foodies use at home. We have a video for the Malden sea salt as well. I did a long time ago. That was one of the first videos I made for this vlog. Check it out. I'll put it in my my end screen there. You can click it if you don't want to find the link anywhere else. But anyway, the whole salt is bad mindset is wrong when you talk about sea salt. It's probably not so bad to follow the salt rule when you're buying commercial foods, because 90% of the foods have just regular ordinary salt in it, which is not good. If you ever see a product that lists sea salt specifically on it, then that's probably not a big deal. It's much better than just salt. So that's it. If you like our video, please hit the subscribe button and all these other things over here, and I'll see you next week.